Chicas. So, it's your girl Olive, and I am at work right now. As you guys can see, I just got here. Oh, I'm sorry, that's my sergeant texting me. So, as you guys can see, I am at work. I'm the only one here right now. I'm waiting for my sergeant to get here. He's running a little late. So, I was like, while I'm here, I wanted to show you guys steps, tricks, and, you know, what is it called? Like, I'm, like, brain farting right now. Steps and tricks and just, not even tricks, but procedures and, you know, stuff about an SPO. So, basically, the first thing I'm going to do is get suited up. My vest is right there on the floor, as you guys can see it. And my duty belt is right here. And I'm going to go ahead and put my duty belt on. I'm not going to put my vest on because I'm not going outside yet. And I don't want to, you know, have that heavy-ass vest on. So I'm just going to get suited up and just put my my duty belt on. I'm going to sign my radio out and my phone. And I'm going to also get my weapon. And I'm going to load that and show you guys how I load my 9mm. I think this is a Glock 17, if I'm not mistaken. But I'll confirm that once I get the weapon. It's either a Glock 17 or a Glock 19. So I'm going to put you guys down, and then I'm going to go ahead and get dressed and get suited up. We'll chat in a little bit. So, my duty belt. So, these are my keepers. These are what keeps the belt, the duty belt, attached to my real belt. So, if I gotta run or anything, it doesn't fall off. So, these are called keepers. For people that don't know what these are keepers. So, before I get any further, so when you wear or when you put on your duty belt has two sides. You have your lethal side and your non-lethal side. Your lethal side is your OC spray side, your weapon side. Your non-lethal side is your mag holders, and I'll show you guys in a little bit. Well, maybe I should show you guys now while I'm talking about it. So you need to have two sides, your non-lethal and your lethal side. Lethal side is your weapon. And I don't have my OC spray on me right now because my pouch kind of broke. So I haven't been wearing my OC spray in a while. But behind my weapon would be my OC spray. And then my extra pair of handcuffs would be in the back. On my non-lethal side, I have my badge, my mag holders, my baton, and my flashlight. And I just have an extra pair of handcuffs on this side right here. So you're not required to have two pairs of handcuffs. Some companies or, you know, agency you work for might say you have to. Ever since I've been an SPO, I had two pairs of handcuffs just in case, you know, my handcuffs aren't big enough for a culprit or a suspect. You know, I have two handcuffs, whatever. So we're gonna carry on. Once everything is secured and ready, you want to put your keepers on. When you buy your keepers, you get a pack of four. Someone stole one of mine like a while back. So now I only have three keepers, so I have compromised. So what I do is I put one right behind my weapon because I need, my weapon is heavy. So I need that side to be, you know, secured. So I put one keeper behind my weapon. I put one in the back where my extra pair of handcuffs are. So my back side is secure, and then I put one on my non-lethal side, normally behind my baton, so that side is secure. So I have two on both sides and one in the back. FYI, when you put your keepers on, you want to make sure that the keeper is going underneath your real belt. So my keeper go underneath here, and that's what holds my duty belt to my real belt to my waist.
You want to always, always, always make sure that your duty belt suits you. Do not do what your homies do or your coworkers do or what other people do. Do what makes you happy and what makes you comfortable, because at the end of the day, you are the one that has to carry all this stuff on you. So do what makes you comfortable. So next, I'm just going to go ahead and get my weapon out the vault and load that up for you guys and show you guys how to load your weapon. So stay tuned.
So I just picked up my weapon, and this is a Glock 17. I love Glock 17s because they are very long and they're comfortable. They fit like perfectly in my hands. Like, so this is locked right now because you guys can see that orange thing on there. That's locked. So that means the weapon is unloaded. It's locked. It won't, if I push on the trigger right now, nothing is going to happen. Like, it's locked. So what I'm going to do is unlock it, and then I am going to load it up for you guys. Okay, so once you unlock the lock for the thing, all you're going to do is just pull that out. On your weapon, there is a slide right here that's just the, that releases the slide. And when you push the slide back, you want to use your finger. I hope you guys can see how I'm doing this. So this button right here, I'm going to pull it push the slide back. And if I had a mag in there, that would put one in the chamber. Since I don't have a mag in there, there's nothing in the chamber. And when you guys load your weapon, always remember muscle retention or muscle memory. Always keep this finger off the trigger. So as you guys see me doing what I'm doing, my finger is off or far away from the trigger as possible, even though the weapon is not loaded. Keep your finger away from that trigger. So what I'm going to do is hold the weapon, and because I'm right-handed, it's kind of weird because I'm right-handed, so it's kind of weird to show you guys, but you want to hold the weapon, hope you guys can see, pull it back, and use your thumb to push this up, and that will hold the thing in order. Okay, so next thing, I have three mags. I carry 30 plus one. 30 plus 1 means I have 30 bullets on me and one already in the chamber just ready for whatever. So I have 30 on me right now, well, 31, and once I load the weapon, one automatically goes into the chamber, which makes it 30 plus 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put these on. So I'm just going to put these in my mag pouch. So a lot of people are really picky as to how, a lot of people, and like I said, when you guys are working with your weapons or whatever, do what makes you comfortable. But a lot of people have specific ways as to how they turn their mags. Like, you know, so it's easier in a case you got to load up or anything. It's so easy to just pull a mag out, load up, cock it back, shoot. But I don't really care how my mags are in, like, that don't really bother me much. I just want to make sure that I have mags on me. But that don't really bother me how they're in. So yeah, let's carry on. So now that my weapon is unloaded, you always want to check. So use your pinky finger just to check to make sure that there's no bullets in here and it's clear. And also look underneath to make sure that your weapon is clear. Once your weapon is clear, you want to put your mag in. The flat side right there goes to the back, and this side points to the front, so it's gonna look like this. See, the flat side goes to the back, and the point where the bullet is facing goes to the front. So you just wanna put it in. A lot of people do that, don't do that. To release the mag, I'm just gonna press this button right here. Mag comes out. When I put it back in, I'm not gonna do that. See, a lot of people do that. Don't do that, that's too much. So once I release it, I'm just gonna put it in. Now there's two ways I can, as you guys can see, there's one right in the chamber. So once I slide this weapon back, this one is already loaded in the chamber and ready to fire. That's why I say keep your finger off that trigger. So there's one right there. I can either pull this down and load it, or I could just pull the weapon back, slide the weapon back, and load it. So I'm gonna show you both ways. The first way is I'm just gonna pull this right here and load the weapon up. So I'm gonna just. So now my weapon is loaded. This is loaded. To unload this, all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna release the slide, the mag, let the mag fall, and then I'm gonna slide that back. And my weapon fall, my extra bullet that was already in, fell on the floor. Let it fall on the floor, y'all. Don't try to catch it. Don't try to do all of that extra stuff. Let it fall on the floor. It's better to let it fall and pick it up than to try to catch it and do all this. Don't. So now that my weapon is unloaded, but I wanna open my slide, I'm just gonna slide it back again and push this button up. So now my weapon is unloaded and secured. Now this is the bullet that fell out when I unloaded. So now I'm just gonna put this back in my mag. And I will try to show you guys on another time how to load your mags, because this is really hard. But you just gotta push it down and slide it back. So now my weapon is secured. There's nothing inside, and everything is loaded here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put it back in. Keep your finger off the trigger. I'm just gonna put it back in, and I'm gonna show you guys the other way to load it. So the first time I pushed this slide down and it just loaded the weapon, or you can just, a lot of people, be careful too. You could just pull the slide back and let go. Now my weapon is loaded. So now that my weapon is loaded, I'm just gonna go ahead and put it on. See, and that's how easy it is. If I didn't have to show you guys step by step and try to explain this stuff to you, this would take me literally 5 seconds to just get suited up. The only thing I have to do is put a vest on and I'm ready for the field. But if you guys have any questions, or you know, if you guys think I did anything wrong, let me know. Please don't be scared to put your comments down below in the comment section. Let me know if you feel like, yeah, Moses, you did something wrong. Yeah, you know what I'm saying, whatever. But yeah, that's just how I get suited up, or that's how majority of the officers get suited up for tour of duty. So yeah, if you guys have any questions, like I said, put that down below in the comment section. I'm going to try to make more of day in the life vlogs of an SPO, but like I said, the area that I'm working in is really dangerous, and I would rather be safe than to try and make videos just for YouTube. You know, like, my safety comes first. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, finish getting dressed for work and chill a little bit until my sergeant gets here. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. Since you want to be fancy with it and shit. It's not fancy.